In this video, we'll be looking at how to find probability using the standard normal table. When you're using a standard normal table that gives probabilities between a mean of 0 and a z value. And we'll work on these 8 examples. Before we get started, let's make sure that you're using the same z table that I'm going to be using. There are multiple versions of the standard normal distribution, or the z table. The one on the far left is the one we'll use in this video. You can see the difference between this version and the other two by taking a look at what is the first value in the upper left of the table. Here you can see it says z at 0 has a probability of 0. And you can see at the shaded area above is showing shading between 0 and a z value. If your table shows something like shaded area to the left of z, and a value of any other probability than 0 in the top left, then you're using a different version of the table. Now, let's talk about how to read this table. The interior of the table is probabilities. For example, this number right here, 0.3686, is 36.86%. If I had solved a problem that gave me a z value of 1.121437. The z table here gives us z's that go out to 2 decimals. The first column of the table is the first 2 decimals of the z, and the first row above is the 3rd decimal of the z. So if we had a z of 1.121437, we would be able to find probability in this table for a z of 1.12. Here's how you find a z. We look at the first column and we find the first 2 digits, and then we go to the first row and we get the 3rd digit of 0.02. The intersection of these 2 values tells us the probability. And the probability that we have just found is between the mean and a z of 1.12, 36.86%. When we talk about this, we talk about area under the curve, or probability, for z at 1.12. In this table, it gave us a probability of 36.86%. If we look at one of the other tables for z, for example, in this table, if I looked at 1.12, you can see that the value is different. It's 0.8686, because this table is giving me the probability of z less than 1.12, and that is 0.8686, which is why it's important to make sure you're using the same table when you look up probabilities as the person in the video. Now let's get started working on some problems. In this first problem, we're going to find the probability between 0 and 1. And how we write it is the probability of 0 less than z less than 1. Let's begin by drawing out a normal curve and showing 0, which is the mean on the standard normal curve, 1, 2, and 3. And these represent number of standard deviations from the mean. And I want to find the area that is between the mean and a z of 1, this piece right here. Well, it turns out when I look this up in the table, I'm going to be looking up 1 in the table. And when I do, I'm actually finding this first value right here, the answer to my question. This is what I want to know, the probability between the mean and 1, and that is the value given in the table. Now let's look at one where we have to do a little bit of work to get to the answer. In this one, we're going to find the probability of z greater than 1. Let's draw this out, and here is 1. On this table. So this would be z equals 1. And we want to find a probability greater than 1. This is what we want to find, the probability of z greater than 1. When we look this up in the table, however, what we look up in the table will be the probability that's between 0 and 1. This is what the table will give us. One property of the standard normal table that you must understand in order to solve these kinds of problems is that 50% of area is to the right of the mean. The probability of z greater than 0 is 50%. If I want to know the probability of z greater than 1, and I can subtract out from my 50% some piece that's up to 1, the leftover will be the chunk that I care about right here. This is going to be the probability of z greater than 0 minus the probability of z between 1 and 0. 0.50 or 50% minus the probability between 0 and 1, 0.3413. And the final answer that I get is 0.1587, or 15.87% of area is to the right of z at 1, which we say as the probability of z greater than 1 equals 0.1587. Now let's take a look at another. In this one, we'll be solving the probability of z being between 1.08 and 2.45. Let's find those values in the table first. 1.08 is going to be at this intersecting point of 0.3599, and 2.45 is going to be at this intersecting point of 0.4929. Let's draw this out on the standard normal curve, and I want to find the area that's between 1.08 and 2.45 right here. This is what we want to find. What I've looked up for 1.08, however, is the area that is in between z of 0 and 1.08, and the area between z of 0 and 2.45. And in order to get this piece right here, I will need to do a little bit of math. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take the larger percentage I found, which is the area that's between the mean and 2.45, and I'm going to subtract from it the area between the mean and 1.08, and the leftover is going to be the result I wanted to get, which will be the area between 1.08 and 2.45. So I'm going to take 0.4929 and subtract from it 0.3599 to get my answer of 0.1530. 15.3% of area is between 1.08 and 2.45 standard deviations. Now let's take a look at if we want to find the probability of z less than 1.67. Again, we'll draw the curve, and 1.67 is right about here. And I would like to find everything to the left of this. However, when I look this up on the z table, it's going to show me the probability at 1.67.4525. So I've just found this bit, 0.4525. We know that everything to the left of 0 is 50% of area. So if I know the piece that's to the right of 0 that I care about, and I actually know what area is to the left of 0, in order to find the probability of z less than 1.67, I take the probability of z less than 0 and add to it what I just found, which is the probability between the mean and z of 1.67. So 0.5 plus 0.4525 gives me the answer of 0.9525. Now let's take a look at some negative z's. You'll notice that this table only has positive z values on it. This is what we call half of a table. It starts at z of 0 and then gives the probability to the right of that between the mean and any value. However, we can use the same table for negative z's because the table is symmetric. Let's take a look. If I want to find the probability between minus 1 and 0, then that's this area right here. I can ignore the negative sign, knowing that the same area is going to be between a z of 0 and a z of 1 as between a z of 0 and minus 1. So I can look this up in the table, and it will be exactly the same on the left-hand side of 0 because they are mirror images of each other. And we already found that answer to be 0.3413. Just as 34.13% is the area under the curve between 0 and 1, it is also the area under the curve between 0 and minus 1. Let's take a look at another. For this one, we'll do the probability of z less than minus 1.96. Drawing out the curve, we want 1.96, which is right about here. Now, when we look this up in the table, just as it would on the right-hand side, it is going to give us the area between minus 1.96 and 0, because the table is always giving us the area between the mean at 0 and a z value, the area right here. We would actually like to find this area. That's what we've been asked to find, the probability of z less than minus 1.96. 50% of area under the curve is to the left of 0. The probability of z less than 0 is 50%. I find that at 1.96, I have 47.5% of area under the curve. So the probability between minus 1.960 is 0.4750. And if I subtract it from 50%, then I get the answer 0.0250. 2.5% of area is to the left of minus 1.96. Now let's look up the area that's between minus 2.75 and minus 0.5. We'll draw out the curve. We are looking for here at minus 2.75 and here minus 0.5. Now if we look at these values in the table, we would ignore the minus sign and go find 0.50 and 2.75. These two values of 0.1915 and 0.4970 are the area under the curve between minus 0.5 and the mean and minus 2.75 and the mean. In order to get the chunk that is between minus 0.5 and minus 2.75, I need to subtract the smaller probability from the larger. 0.4970, which represents the entire distance between the mean and minus 2.75, and 0.1915, which represents only that small chunk between minus 0.5 and the mean. The leftover will be the probability of finding a value that's between minus 0.5 and minus 2.75 standard deviations. And the answer to that is 0.3055, or 30.55% of area is between minus 0.5 and minus 2.75 standard deviations. On this one, we'll do the probability between minus 2.18 and 1.96. Let's circle those numbers in the table. 2.18 will be over here, and 1.96 will be here. We have just circled numbers that represent area here, probability of 0 less than z less than 1.96, and here, the probability between minus 2.18 and the mean. Well, it turns out that that's exactly what we want in this problem. We actually want to know the probability that is between minus 2.18 and 1.96. If we add these two probabilities together, we will have the entire probability, 0.4750 and 0.4854 will give us the answer of 0.9604, or 96.04% of area is between minus 2.18 and 1.96 standard deviations. In this video, we have looked at how to use the standard normal table, which gives half of the area under the curve from z at 0 to the right, in order to solve any probability for z, negative or positive. I hope you found this helpful.